Welcome inside of the Cabinet Design of Pella Radio postgame show, where the Pella High boys basketball team has beaten Winterset 51-45, and the Dutch are headed to the Class 3A state tournament for the first time since 2021, their third state title year. Let's take a look at our McCall Monument Radio Monumental Play and Player of the Game.
I think you could go Austin Schulte, player of the game, certainly the play of the game. I've got to say something about one of the seniors.
Luke Hardman.
Well, I'm actually going to say Cam Rowe.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, I mean, I know it doesn't show up on the stat sheet, but I thought his plays down, I mean, he scored in the fourth quarter, which he hadn't done the rest of the game.
And no points, and then he gets five all in the fourth quarter.
He has five all in the fourth, but had some big, big-time assists, and just really just heads-up plays that I thought in that fourth quarter were good because, you know, let's be honest, you go down to the state tournament, I doubt we're going to go shoot lights out 50% from three. You got to learn to win ugly, and tonight was that.
Welcome back inside of our Cabinet Design of Pella Radio postgame show on 92.1 KRLS. It's our continuing coverage of Pella High boys basketball as the state tournament-bound Dutch have defeated Winterset 51-45, and we've got the whole senior crew up here to talk about their trip next week to Wells Fargo Arena. Up next is Cameron Rowe, Dutch 51, Winterset 45, as we're talking postgame of Pella's victory over Winterset to go to the state tournament. Cam, congratulations to you, headed to the state tournament. What are your thoughts on that?
Again, just super excited. We've been working for this since kindergarten. We appreciate our whole coaching staff, our players, and the fans all being energetic.
Winterset gave you everything you wanted tonight. Their defense was as tenacious as I've seen, and we've seen some pretty good ones in the Little Hawkeye Conference. What kind of challenges did they present to you guys tonight?
Yeah, their on-ball pressure was really good, and we really liked that because it prepares us not only for this game, but then also in the state tournament after. And we just liked the energy that they brought so that we could kind of feed off that.
And what did Coach talk to you about in the fourth quarter? Several timeouts, just trying to keep things, because you're down by six in the fourth and then outscored them 13-1 the rest of the way. What was the message, and how did you guys execute that?
Yeah, so luckily our players did a great job keeping composure, so Coach didn't have to worry about that. He could actually talk about scheme and not have to worry about that. And so he was just telling us, you know, keep working. We're a fourth quarter team and played that the whole second half of the season. So just go out there, trust our guys, and work hard.
You were, four of 18 shooting three-pointers through the first three quarters. Not very good per your standards. And then didn't shoot one in the fourth quarter. I don't know if you know that or not, but was that just, you know, by design, or was it because things were open elsewhere? You guys were very aggressive going to the rim.
Yeah, so we definitely still trust our three-point shooters, but we really, when we were in the huddle, we were like, we really got to attack the rim. We know everybody here can get to the rim. So, you know, make a couple ball fakes, get them out of the way, and then go in, drive hard, play off two, be strong.
All right, what does Big Bro think of this one?
He was really excited. He was just talking to me. He said he was more excited than when they made it. So I really appreciate him being able to be here. And, yeah, he was just really excited.
And has he passed down any kind of wisdom or any thoughts on what it takes to be successful next week?
Yeah, definitely. Before the game, he just kind of just talked to me. He's like, you know, play your game. You know, you play basketball enough, you know how to handle this. And just go out there and work harder.
All right, we'll see you next week. Thanks a lot, Cam.
Appreciate
Good job.
That.
Cam Rowe of the Pella High boys basketball team. Final score here on Monday night, Pella 51, Winterset 45, and we're nowhere near done.
Dead. I slapped my girl, she called the feds. I did that time and spent that bread. I'm headed home, I'm almost there. I'm on my way, headed up the stairs. To my surprise, a nigga replacing me. I had to take him to that ghetto university.
All the lights,
top lights, flashlights, spotlights, strobe lights. in that order. Public visitation. We met at Borders. Told her she'd take me back. I'll be more supportive. I made mistakes. I bumped my head. And court sucked me dry. I spent that bread. She need a daddy. Baby, please. Can't let her grow up in that ghetto university.
All of the lies.
Top lights, flashlights, spotlights, strobe lights, street lights.
All of the lies. All of the lies.
Fast life, drug life.